Materials used are blue and purple fabric paint, paint brush, water containers, rubber bands, ice cubes, double layer strainer bowl set, fabric pen, and of course a t-shirt. I'm starting by making my fabric water, and here I'm using blue and purple fabric paints to create a nice shade. Now I'm taking the strainer bowl which already has the t-shirt crumpled in it, and then I am adding ice and the fabric water unevenly in the bowl, and I'll be leaving this alone for almost 6 to 7 hours. Post washing the t-shirt, I realized that the color of the t-shirt was too light, so I decided to try a different tie-dye technique this time. After flattening the t-shirt, I'm creating plaits or doing the fan fold from one side of the t-shirt and then taking a turn and completing the fold on the same side. Now on equal intervals, I am tightly tying rubber bands. Now take a container or a plait and place the tie t-shirt in it. Now on alternate sections, I'm pouring blue and lavender fabric paint water, and because my water container had flat edges, I had to use a spoon to pour the water on the each section. Once done, leave it to dry overnight.
Approximately 10 hours later.
Okay, so after washing, this is how the color has turned out. The lavender color has completely faded away. There is no touch of lavender or purple in this t-shirt. But yes, there is a really beautiful pattern of light blue and white concentric circles on the t-shirt. I don't think it's visible on the camera, but it looks really good in person. And fabric water is just a substitute for dyes, and I don't think it works that well with darker colors, but it works really well with the lighter ones. So all in all, I did like the t-shirt. The back side of the t-shirt was a little lighter, so I decided to do a line art on that side and just a small tiny logo of S on the front side so that it's kind of balanced out.
So I did not record the part where I was doing the line art or painting the logo because I didn't want the video to be very long. So if you want to check out how I do the drawing part and the outlining and the painting on t-shirt, then you can check out my previous t-shirt video. The link will be in the description.
And if you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram.